The failure to renew Geraldine Ssali's contract means she exits employment with the fund effective 29th October 2017. Patrick Michael Ayuta, the fund's chief finance officer, has been appointed deputy managing director effective 29th October 2017. So who is Patrick Ayuta, the new deputy managing director? Patrick Michael Ayuta has been appointed the fund's deputy managing director for a period of 5 years, effective 29th October 2017. He has been the fund's chief finance officer since 2011. Prior to joining the fund, he was the finance director at Barclays Bank, Uganda. He has extensive experience in accounting and finance management gained over the years in various senior management roles on the USA. Patrick has an MBA from the University of South Carolina in USA and a Bachelor's of Science in Finance from Liberty University, Virginia. Patrick has been at the forefront of various projects at the fund, which he steered successfully, and was recently appointed runner-up at the 2017 Chief Finance Officer of the Year Awards. Meanwhile, Richard Wejuli Wabwire has been reappointed Corporation Secretary. Previously, he had similar responsibilities in Uganda Breweries Limited, Century Bottlers Limited, and National Water and Sewerage Corporation, among other organizations. The NSSF outgoing Deputy Managing Director, Geraldine Ssali Busuulwa, has been in the past 3 years in the news for good, bad, and odd reasons. While several people believe that during these years she had exhibited some imbued perseverance, her biggest undoing has been her endless clashes with her bosses, NSSF Richard Byarugaba, and the entire board. At the peak of these, NSSF board versus deputy MD battles last year, the board suspended Geraldine Ssali on grounds of indiscipline. In response, she sued NSSF, the board chairman Patrick Byabakama Kaberenge, and Richard Byarugaba. The courts later cancelled her suspension and reinstated her in office pending investigations into her alleged insubordination. However, 2 days after the court order, the security guards at Worker's House blocked her from entering her office, forcing her to go to court and sue Byarugaba and Kaberenge over contempt of a court.